In this illustration, we'll analyze the momentum imparted by a bouncing ball. Here we are given that a steel ball of mass m falls from a height h on a horizontal surface of a table. We are required to find the total momentum imparted by ball to table after numerous bounces if every impact decreases the velocity of ball by n times. Here, if we analyze the situation, this is, say, the table on which a ball falls from a height h. And when it strikes with a velocity v1, we are given that after every impact, its velocity decreases by n times. So, it will rebound with a velocity v1 by n and so on. So, here we can write the velocity of ball at first impact is this v1 we can write as root 2gh because it is in free fall motion. And here we can say when it rebounds, its velocity becomes v1 by n. So, we can calculate at the second impact, the velocity v2 can be written as v1 by n. And similarly, at third impact, if we calculate, this will be v3, which is v2 by n. So, we can write it as v1 by n square and so on. So, we can calculate the momentum imparted to table after numerous bounces by ball is, this can be written as delta p, which is equals to m. The very first impact, the momentum imparted is v1 plus v1 by n. After second impact, it is m multiplied by v2 plus v2 by n and so on up to several times. Here we can write v2 as v1 by n and this will become v1 by n square. So, in this situation, we can take mv1 common out. So, inside we'll be having 1 plus, this will be 2 by n plus 2 by n square plus and so on up to infinite times. As n is greater than 1, this will be a converging GP for which we can write delta p is mv1 plus 2mv1 by n multiplied by 1 plus 1 by n plus 1 by n square and so on. And the sum of this converging GP we can write as delta p is equals to mv1 plus 2mv1 by n multiplied by, this is written as a upon 1 minus common ratio. So, it is 1 divided by 1 minus 1 by n. So, further on simplifying, this gives us mv1 and inside it is 1 plus 2 by n minus 1, which is equals to m multiplied by v1 as root 2gh, and inside it is n plus 1 upon n minus 1. This is the final result of this problem.